We're hoping to get into the upper 40s at the high point for the day.
A cold and crisp morning with clear blue skies. January 28, 1986. The crew of Space Shuttle Challenger prepared to make history.
In the foreground now, preparing to put on their egress harnesses, is Greg Jarvis and Christa McAuliffe. Christa McAuliffe was selected out of 11,000 teacher applicants.
With the entire country watching, Concord's Christa McAuliffe was on the verge of becoming the first teacher in space.
The teacher observer, Christa McAuliffe, has been handed an apple by the closeout crew. And liftoff! Liftoff!
But seconds later, Challenger fell back to Earth. Its crew lost forever, but their spirit is never forgotten.
To follow your instincts and go for your dreams, and I hope they achieve that.
Good evening from the McAuliffe-Shepard Discovery Center in Concord. I'm Tom Griffith.
And I'm Jennifer Vaughn. 25 years ago today, time stood still. The feeling was magical as Space Shuttle Challenger lifted away from Cape Canaveral, Florida. Then the dangers of the mission were realized. The entire crew was killed. Christa McAuliffe, a teacher, wife, and mother, a hero in New Hampshire, was gone. Over the next hour, we'll remember Christa and her dreams and show you how her passion is still alive in the Granite State.
We start with a look back from WMUR's Andy Hershberger.
She was a true pioneer on the last frontier, blessed with a rare fusion of courage, character, and charm. Christa McAuliffe was a natural. She was a leader while comfortably wearing the mantle of wife and mother. She was smart, yet disarming with her simple, anything-is-possible attitude. As a girl, Christa marveled at the early days of the space program. As a woman, she yearned to be part of it. In 1985, Christa was a teacher at Concord High School, where she instructed courses in economics, law, and American history. It was President Ronald Reagan who pitched the idea to put a teacher in space, in part to generate interest in NASA and to increase the profile of the space shuttle program.
After extensive interviews, these 10 teachers will now vie for the one spot designated by President Reagan to put an educator in space.
Christa McAuliffe was one of 11,000 applicants from across the country, but became a finalist for the Teacher in Space program.
I couldn't believe it. In fact, it wasn't until the next morning I was still kind of pinching myself, trying to make sure that I was one of the 10.
Christa McAuliffe will fly to Houston Monday to begin extensive testing of her physical and psychological makeup. Tonight, it was off to her home in Concord. Come January, it may be off to the stars.
And the winner, the teacher who will be going into space, Christa McAuliffe.
She had earned the right to voyage toward the stars with the crew of the Space Shuttle Challenger.
I always ask my students, to go and seek whatever they feel they can do and reach a little higher.
In her training, Christa charged forward with her trademark enthusiasm and humor.
Lunch is served.
Her part of the mission was to teach a class from space through closed-circuit TV to more than 1 million students across the country. To the nation, she was the astronaut teacher, but to her local high school, she was a teacher turned hero. And to New Hampshire, she was a proud representative of the state's rugged spirit.
This is a News 9 special report, the launch of the Challenger.
Lauren Baker has been in Florida since late Wednesday. She has been watching all the developments of Christa McAuliffe and her space shuttle crew.
It's a terrific day down here. I've got to tell you, the skies are blue, the winds are light. It is very, very chilly, though. It's only about 30 degrees right now.
The mission had to be scrubbed twice because of weather and mechanical issues. But on Tuesday, January 28, 1986, the clock slowly ticked toward liftoff.
Concord High School also obviously has a great deal of interest in today's space launch. Judy Fortin is there.
Well, Odetta, Concord High School officials are playing it safe today. Until they get the word, the launch is on at 11:38. They're going to keep students in classes.
Good morning, Christa. Hope we go today.
Good morning. Hope so, too.
Again, the launch faced delays, primarily because of cold weather, a factor that would, in part, ultimately determine the shuttle's fate.
Well, today we're just going to send up the balloons. We thought that would look nice, and maybe she can even see them. And we hope to put the banner that's now in the cafeteria outside so everyone can see it.
What does the banner say?
It says, "We're with you, Christa."
We just hit the T-minus 9 mark just now, and a moment ago, NASA control said the status as of the moment is a go, so everything looks very, very good.
When Christa comes back, you planning a big party, too?
We were talking about having a big welcome home party and maybe a dance, and we were hoping to show some slides of what's been going on while she's gone.
We have main engine start, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
It's almost out of view from the naked eye right now, and you can see the one.
1 minute 15 seconds, velocity 2900 feet per second, altitude 9 nautical miles, downrange distance 7 nautical miles. Flight controllers here looking very carefully at the situation. Obviously a major malfunction.
The flight of the Challenger lasted 73 seconds. The images will last forever.
It is just stunned silence here. We do not know exactly what happened. It looked like a fire, an explosion. It is very hard to tell.
Christa McAuliffe, the first pure civilian, the first teacher in space, with her parents and lots of children in attendance from her school at Cape Canaveral today. 24 space missions had already been accomplished before a tragedy occurred on this one.
I had hope for them, and I thought it was just the shuttle was in one piece in the water. I really didn't think that they'd be dead.
Some people were covering their eyes, and some people were just watching the TV set with a blank look on their face.
In an instant, Christa McAuliffe was gone. For America, it was a national tragedy. But for New Hampshire, it was far more personal.
She was a part of us. She was part of a family. And just like, if your sister or brother died, she'll be remembered.
I don't think there's any question that she infected us all with her enthusiasm. And in addition to a loss to the family, it's a loss to the state and a loss to the nation.
Oh, she's so nice. She's just a real caring, kind person. She's like a, well, she's kind of like a big sister to me, kind of. She's just really special. It's hard.
Christa McAuliffe fearlessly chased her dream, but dreams come at a price, and that price is often high. A presidential report revealed that the explosion was probably caused by a faulty pressure seal and that cold weather played a role in that failure. The death of all 7 crew members, viewed by millions of people, highlighted the inherent danger of space exploration. And it was that danger that Christa stared in the eye and brushed aside with a smile.
And while with silent, lifting mind, I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God. Christa, you have touched the face of God, and I ask you to ask Him to be kind to me and to all of us.
Hundreds of people attended that memorial service at the State House in Concord.
And dozens of services were held all around the country, honoring the entire crew. Challenger Commander Dick Scobie, Pilot Michael Smith, Mission Specialist Ronald McNair, Judith Resnick, and Allison Onizuka, Payload Specialist Greg Jarvis, and Teacher Astronaut Christa McAuliffe.
And when Remembering Challenger continues,
it was so exciting. I don't know that I've ever experienced a buildup to something that let me down as much.
Anticipation turns to heartache for a friend and co-worker of Christa McAuliffe. her memories from the launch, and the things she says almost kept Christa from being the teacher aboard Challenger.
Plus,
I remember the day that it happened too, and just seeing their family looking up and wondering what was going on, the doubt and all that. Just you'll never forget it.
The moment forever etched in the minds of Granite Staters, and the ways some are making sure Krista's memory lives on.